I have received some of the nicest comments from viewers who were happy I took the time to add YouTube subtitles and YouTube translations. My channel has grown significantly because of my taking these steps with all of my videos. Now, you could pay to have someone do this for you, but today I will show you how I do this without it costing me anything but a little bit of my time. I also have an additional translation bonus at the end, so stay tuned. I'm Naomi Skrzynski with the Top Shelf VA channel, your place for creativity and inspiration for business and life. If you're new to the channel, please take 1 second and click on the subscribe button, click on the bell icon, and check notifications for Top Shelf VA. Okay, let's quickly look at the two largest benefits of using the YouTube closed caption feature and adding translations for your YouTube subtitles. The first benefit is you open your video up to the possibilities of more individuals finding your video from other countries who are not native speakers of your language. The second and largest benefit is you can build your subscriber base faster. Here's an example of my subscriber growth starting in 2016 prior to doing translations. May 2016, 12 subscribers. June 2016, 5 subscribers. July 2016, 13 subscribers. Not too great. Now, in August 2016, I started adding translations for other languages. What a big difference! August 2016, 33 subscribers. September 2016, 29 subscribers. October 2016, 38 subscribers. As you can see, adding translations to my videos was highly beneficial for my channel. For my channel, that was an average of a 233% increase in monthly subscribers by simply adding YouTube subtitle translations in comparison to not having them at all. Okay, now that I have your attention, let's learn how to do this. The first step is to create a YouTube closed caption transcript of your video in your native language. In all cases, the format of the file should be as follows. Save the transcript in a text format. Each sentence should be its own paragraph line. Make sure all punctuation is used and accurate, because accurate punctuation will help with the context of the translation. The text file must be as perfect as possible. Now, there are several ways to create a transcript without costing you anything but your time. Here are the top three. The fastest and easiest ways are before you even go into YouTube. If you use a teleprompter, that means you already have a full script before recording your video. Most of the job is done for you. Simply listen to the final rendered video while looking at your script, stop the video in any locations where you used a different word, and make the changes needed for accuracy. Another choice is using your laptop or cell phone while video recording. Have it close enough to you so the laptop's microphone will pick up your voice. Open Google Docs in Chrome. Click on Tools, click on Voice Typing, then click on the microphone to speak. Google will pick up your voice and type out what you say. However, it's not always accurate and you won't be stating the punctuation while recording your video. You will have to go back and make all the corrections for typos, punctuation, and line spacing while listening to the final of your video. It will also sometimes arbitrarily stop recording if it can't keep up with you or isn't hearing your voice. Google Voice typing is a little frustrating for me and time consuming, which is why I like transcribing directly if I had not done a fully scripted video. Transcribing the rendered video as I listen to it is the fastest for me because transcribing has been part of my business for years. I can transcribe the video using transcription software that lets me listen to the video or audio portion of the video while typing, using hotkeys to pause, slow down, speed up, etc. Once you have the final, clean, completely accurate transcription file saved as a text file, it's on to YouTube. After loading your video to your YouTube channel, click on Video Manager. Click on the Edit button for the video, then Subtitle CC to open the YouTube Subtitles closed caption work area. Click on the Add New Subtitles or CC, and then select English or your native language. Three choices for creating your YouTube subtitles will appear. Let's start at the bottom. Create new subtitles or CC. Now this is the slowest way. When you click on this, the automated transcript with timings will appear on the left and the video on the right. You will then have to listen to the video and watch the transcript, making all corrections, punctuation marks to the script as the video plays, stopping and starting all along the way. As I said, very slow. Another choice is transcribe and auto sync. This actually is the fastest way. When you click on the YouTube transcribe and auto sync button, it opens the video on the left with an empty box for you to type in while transcribing the video. This is where it was beneficial working on the transcript outside of YouTube. Simply open your script text file from Notepad, copy all the text by highlighting it and pressing Ctrl plus C for copy. Then put your cursor in the blank box and paste the text by pressing Ctrl plus V for a paste. Then click on Set Timing. The third way, upload a file, is similar but slightly slower. After you click on the button, it will open with the transcript on the left, the video on the right, and a pop-up box with the transcript radio button selected. Browse to where your file is located and select it, and then click on Upload. You will see the transcript in the box now. However, apostrophes and quotation marks will have strange ASCII characters. You will have to open the text file, copy the text, and paste it over the text in the box, then select timings. As you can see, this is why the transcribe and autosync is your fastest selection for adding the YouTube closed captions transcript. Once you have set the timings, you will see it is in the My Drafts section indicating it is setting the timings. While it is setting the timings, what I do is go to my Info and Settings section and upload my customized thumbnail, add my title, my description, and my tags, all of which I researched and wrote prior to even starting my video. I also add it to the appropriate playlist and click on Save Changes. By this time, the YouTube subtitles timings should have been set. I go back to the subtitle CC area and click on the button under My Drafts, which is my main language, English. I then set the speed of the video at 1.5 times and listen to it while I watch the transcript for any minute errors I may not have caught the first time around. Remember, I want this to be as perfect as possible in my language. Once I am satisfied, I will click on Save Changes. Although it says here the subtitles are published, you will see at the bottom your new subtitles are in the process of being published under Pending Publish. While I wait for that to fully publish, I will get a screenshot from a previous video of the languages I have been translating to. Your question may be, well, how do I know what languages I should translate to? There are two ways to do this. The first is to go to your YouTube Analytics overview page and scroll down to the bottom. Click on Top Geographies. This will give you a list of the top countries currently viewing your videos. You can use the language of those countries. If you have TubeBuddy, you can go to the Video Translations tab, scroll down, and TubeBuddy will show you the top 10 languages spoken by your channel's audience. This is a good place to start. Since I've been doing this for over a year, I simply go to a previous video, grab a screenshot of the languages under the Subtitle CC section, and put that on my second monitor or to the side, so I don't forget a language. I then go back to the new video I was working on and to the YouTube Subtitle CC section. Now we see our English translation has fully published and we can now delete the automated version by clicking on it, clicking on Unpublish, Delete Draft, and Delete Draft again. YouTube tells me the draft has been discarded and the only version currently in the YouTube Subtitle CC queue is the perfect English transcript I created. Creating the translations is now very straightforward. Select Add New Subtitles or CC. In the box where it says Search 187 Other Languages, start typing in your first language. Mine is Arabic. A drop-down appears that allows you to pick the language you want if you don't want to type it all the way. The next screen shows the language you have selected, which in this case is Arabic. Click on Create New Subtitles or CC. The next window shows you that it will be transcribing from English to Arabic. Click on Auto Translate, then click on Save Changes. Now move on down the list of your languages you would like to translate to and do the same process. Add New Subtitles or CC, type in the language and select it, Create New Subtitles or CC, Auto Translate, and Save Changes. Keep doing this until you have created translations for all the languages on your list. Now for the translation bonus I promised. Here is how you handle the translations for your title and description. In a separate browser window, open translate.google.com and click on Translate a Document. Go back to your YouTube Info and Settings tab and click on Translations. Your original language should be showing, which in my case is English. Copy the title and place it in the box on the left-hand side of the Google Translate tab. Return to add a paragraph. Go back to YouTube and copy the full description and paste it underneath the title in Google. On the right-hand side of YouTube, click on Select Language. Type in the first language and select it from the drop-down. Click on Add Language. Go back to Google and select the language, and if it is not showing, click on the drop-down arrow, which will give you a full selection of languages. Select the language you need, then copy the full translated language on the right-hand side of Google. Go back to YouTube and paste it in the main box. Take the first line paragraph, which is the title, and cut it by pressing Ctrl plus X. Delete the extra line space that is remaining to bring the description to the top. Place your cursor in the title area and paste the title you just cut by pressing Ctrl plus V. Click on Save Changes. Now move on to the next language on your list. Under Translate Into, click on the drop-down arrow and Add New Language. Click on Select Language and type in your next language and add a language. Go back to Google and click on the drop-down arrow to select the new language. Copy the translation and paste it into YouTube. Cut out the first line and remove the extra line space. Paste the first line, which is the title, into the title area and save changes. Keep doing this process until the title and description has been translated into all the languages you needed for your channel. After that, it's simply a matter of finalizing your video with cards and end cards, looking for anything you might have missed, and publishing the video. I saw my monthly subscriber growth begin to happen within about 30 days. Hopefully, it will be the same for you. If you liked this video, you may like watching one of my other training videos. Remember to subscribe and leave a comment below. I'm constantly taking requests and learning from your feedback on what you would like to learn. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.